Hayden. And my connection's better this time.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, no. Guys, if you think this is crazy, the Rams passed 53 times with Case Keenum. Why would you do that when you have Todd Gurley? This is just so bad coaching. Did you hear me, Hayden, about that? I can barely hear you, Hayden.
That was my fault.
Go.
We are set, ready to rock for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. And these guys on your screen, ready to rock as well. Some of the stars of today's game. And speaking of the game, let's get right to it.
Go. Please let me get. Oh, I'm going to have to freaking return.
Here's Travis comes now ready to get this one started.
Yo, let's go. Let's go, David Johnson.
Ultimate team is underway.
What?
And they're going to start this drive.
Move.
In good shape as they get it up.
Let's go. Let's go. Yo, I got to run my offense. Let's go. I find my check downs if I need to.
They go play action here on
look at that check down. Look at check down.
That's complete to his running back.
Crap.
Todd Gurley to the house. Todd Gurley.
66 yards.
Let's go.
First quarter lead.
14-second drive. Wow, that was laggy, and I missed it. Dang it.
Fun missed field goal.
Then a back who's a complete guy who can run it and catch it, and we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
Dang it, it's laggy.
Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. This is fielded
at the ball charge. Oh, good hit. Let's see your offense, see if y'all can do that. Bro, I love to play D. Go Lamar Houston. Go Urlacher.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. And that will be caught.
Crap.
But out of bounds.
Incomplete
here. So the incomplete pass brings up second down.
That was a nice catch, but unable to stay in bounds. And remember, it wasn't a wide receiver who works on that all the time.
Aaron Donald!
Wilson's gonna go down. Aaron Donald continuing to fight downfield. The big tackle gets him for a loss of 11. Third and long, it's Wilson.
Look at that.
Wilson's gonna be incomplete.
Go, fourth down.
That's the one he was looking for. And now it's fourth down. So on fourth down, here's the veteran
left-footed
punter Downey Jones to kick it away. Back deep, Antonio Brown.
Go, AB. Get a nice return. Oh, man, I got blockers.
Let's take it inside his own 40.
Get off me. Ah!
And 9 yards there on the return following a punt of 47. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Here's the Lion offense now as they get ready to take over.
Go.
And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time. Let's see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last
true.
Time.
That's
I mean,
true.
That's what you're working on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense. Not giving up the long pass. They
Man.
Do. We'll see how they adjust. On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it.
It's in the heat. Dang it.
Cliff Avril in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Well, there was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want.
Oh, my.
Avril, getting in there with
him.
Sack.
In there to get him. His second sack now.
when I was a kid, and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. Five defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sacks.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the breakfast, so I could pay the
five. Oh, okay.
What were they?
15 cents.
And a fair catch taken back near about the 35, 36-yard line. A special teams mistake there, no doubt. Just 26 yards officially on the punt. And the Panthers will get it here as they take possession. On first down, Wilson.
Incomplete! Incomplete! Good hit, Honey Badger!
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
He's going to air one out. And that's caught inside the 35. Touchdown, Carolina.
Half step and he's breaking.
65 yards. And his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead. That was the fly route for a touchdown. I got to tell the story before the game. We were standing there. He was running deep routes, dropped one. It bounced up and just hit me right in the gut. I said, come on, man. But there was no drop.
Yeah, you okay now?
I'm good.
All right,
good.
We got the ice pack up here. You're just fine. What I loved about it was the first and foremost. But sometimes it's a head fake. It's varying your speed off the line of scrimmage. It's giving the defensive back different angles to think about. Is he going inside? Is he going outside? And then, as you noted, he just took off past it. Oops, there he goes again.
Ooh, this play is so cash.
And it'll be second down.
Muhammad Wilkerson elevated a Temple program that was looking for players like him, and he's carried that on into the NFL. What a terrific player.
Well, this is terrible. It's complete. An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
Not the tallest receiver on the field, but he just shouted to admit that the little guy can't go downfield and make a big-time catch on a deep pass, because sometimes they'll just have
to Charles! The football. Oh, Charles! Good run!
The 35-yard line. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
I just love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level.
Terrence Newman with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out.
Oh my goodness! I gotta get my Kevin!
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time and allowed for the big completion downfield. Those guys made that play possible.
Over the middle. Fumble!
No!
And it's a fumble.
Yeah!
Big turnover there as his guys will get
the ball. Dude, stand, boy.
And Detroit getting set to
go. Houston, we have a problem.
Something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
Houston, we have a problem.
The number they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence.
Oh, girly, another one.
You can't get that back.
Let's go. Hurry up.
I'm going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better. So what's the old expression that quarterbacks like to use when they decide to throw the football? I'm looking for either a
touchdown
or a check down. And he took the check down.
Let's go!
And it worked almost to perfection.
That one goes for 24 yards. On that catch, he's already eclipsed 100 yards here in the first quarter. Charles, he's on pace for over 400.
And playing with great confidence.
You sacked me.
They'll sack him on what ought to be the final
play. Oh, snap. I'm going out of you.
Here with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, as the Lions are in possession of the football here to begin quarter number two. But they face a second and long to start things out. One receiver left, two to the right.
This is going to be confusing.
On second down. Here's Wilson.
Hold the ball! That's all I asked you.
Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football.
Line,
if someone's trying to throw the ball, and you put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Fucking my God! I mean, block it, stupid
kid. Eat him up. And they're going to go for it.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. That's exactly what happened on that play.
They're going on fourth down. It's Wilson. He's going to look deep down the field.
Yes, he picked it. That's better.
It's a play. Stupid.
That's like a punt for me.
Smack it out there, stupid.
Last time, but fumbled and turned it over, so they'll be looking to have a short-term memory here, Mr. Davis.
Not only a short-term memory.
How in the world? You've got a quarter. I mean, we got two people on the guy.
Scoring some points, they got to feel pretty good about. They thought they had things in the direction last time. Fumbles, they don't just affect you on offense, they affect your overall team because now your defense has to make that.
Oh my goodness! Look at that jailbreak!
And now it's second down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye and there was a loss on the play.
Look at that! Kenny!
It's incomplete.
Hey, how you like that Auburn game, son? That was
awesome.
I know you were there, but still. I mean, I didn't mean to tell.
Wilson, he's going to launch this thing way down.
Yeah, Tyrone! Honey, by Johnson!
That was a long pass attempt.
Honey, by Johnson!
Popped up in the air. And how come things go from really fast to almost slow motion when the ball's up in the air and the defender's unable to haul it in before it hits the ground?
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Change of possession here on the punt.
Come on, let's go. Return team. I mean, whatever.
First and 10. The Lions offense,
let's go.
Onto the field. And two interceptions thrown here.
That's cool. This play is lovely.
They say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw two interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny United.
Double team. Crap.
Whoa!
Let's go.
Let's go. Sorry, stop.
And I thought, what is he smiling about? It's because he had enough confidence in himself that that was a fluke. And he went out and played pretty well the rest of the day.
Here's Wilson.
What? Oh.
Two plays in a tightly contested first half. We'll come back to Ford Field after this. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Second and 10 now, Wilson.
Don't kill him.
And in.
Are you kidding me?
Jars the ball free.
No.
And brings up third down. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down.
Come on, we've got to have it.
On third down, Wilson.
Hey, awful throw! I mean, come on! You gotta cover him too, Morgan! And you're stupid! Get off of that forward! It's literally a buster!
See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you gotta feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Second and 10, it's Wilson again.
That's me!
Looking for Evans. And they will set up shop at their own 41-yard line. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think there's any way you can run.
Look at this! Girlies! Oh! Give me those ankles!
You have to be careful about being too cautious. catches because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Now a play fake here on first down.
Look at this. One on one.
Oh
my goodness.
He got wrecked.
I know.
Second down now after the incompletion.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
They go play action with Wilson.
Still stats.
What was that covering? Jeez, that was awful covering.
Yeah.
A good grab there by the former Central Michigan man, Antonio Brown.
And he ate up some real estate on the catch, too, didn't he? I think the most impressive part of it, though, if there's
what
a chance for
doing?
Him to get the football,
boy,
even
Russell
though he was
Wilson.
Covered well,
what are you
he
doing?
Somehow finds a way to get it.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six.
And that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. It's the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu.
Honey Badger, please. Two out of
our. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm here, my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win.
Strip it!
Last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about.
Minimizing
don't
those
touch that,
and maximizing opportunities. That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Hold them to a
I'm
game
not done
two.
Yet, Harper.
That changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and
Hop
eight.
Him.
Now
yeah.
They probably think about
we're
going to the
yet,
air
though.
Instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
A really good pickup of 28 yards.
You got 2 seconds.
So we have reached halftime here with not much scoring between these two teams. 6-6 our score. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports halftime report. Larry, so both teams have their marching orders and we'll get going again here in quarter number three.
Pop him.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the
decision.
He's taken down right at the 20-yard line. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense.
You can test me all you want, but don't test my you.
Our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't
don't
it?
Don't touch it!
Both sides trying to seize momentum to begin.
I was following that!
That'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield.
Let's find out what they
I'm
have.
I'm going. You're SWAT, man.
Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. Evans has it left side.
I mean, geez, that guy is eating up.
And now a first down following that long gain. And
my guy is at 4 receptions for 150
yards now on the game charges.
And now it's not just execution. It's not just performance. It's a mental aspect that's going on. Because right now, he's got the defense so much on their heels. Got them looking at each other. Who's going to cover this guy? And what type of coverage can we put out there to try and slow him down?
Now it's Wilson. Over the middle here to Brown.
Pop him! You've got fools there for a reason!
The catch and run. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Slam routes are something no matter who's running.
I know who you're throwing
to. When you receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
They snap it at one. Now Wilson. That is
my safeties are getting burnt. Jump on the freaking ball. Make a play.
Against the wall.
Make a play.
The offense is in the red zone. Charles the lone setback. The pigskin on his 7-yard line. Now it's first and goal.
Yeah.
And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
Cameron White makes plays like that look simple because I think he plays with excellent leverage. Really does a nice job.
Watch me
trying to block him. He gets underneath them and goes up and down the line of scrimmage to make those types of plays.
They kept him to a short run play there. Now Wilson on second down.
Fullback throw.
And it's incomplete. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, This feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides. With attention.
Boom! Aaron Donald!
There to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Now here's the Panthers special teams unit to try a field goal for three. From the right hash, just a 34-yard attempt. And Coons connects on this one. It's good. And they take the lead here as it's now 9-6. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point. So no problems converting there.
Fielded about a yard deep.
Oh, maybe. Oh, man! He had a crease, too. Bob got just a little bigger one.
So we get a look at the Lions' offense as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed
how
they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second half?
You're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
Let's go.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store.
We don't talk anymore like we used to do.
Second and 10 now, Wilson.
Come on! Throw the ball!
Incomplete.
You gotta give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away. And that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because
for
the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and give some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
On third down, Wilson. He's going to loft one deep left side here. So they
Wilson!
Get it. Now it's four.
I'm looking.
One of the toughest things about
you sure are.
Pattern reading, trying to
that is the
wide
openest thing imaginable.
With the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly. But
why are you looking for the ball?
And the Panthers are going to get it back.
I mean, what are you thinking? A precipice edge, and it's looking like he doesn't know what to do. He got to get a stop.
They're going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the
yeah! He's got a field goal right now! Dan Williams!
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
On second down, here's Wilson. And the hit turned it loose.
Yeah! Good goal!
You know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Throwing is Wilson. Wilson, it's loose.
But that guy's better than your finger.
Oxygen tank ready. Touchdown, Lions. So his defense makes the play. They return it for the score, and now
touchdown, Dan Williams. He just caught
in the second half. They give the ball up, and all of a sudden they're behind.
Big time fumble. And he atones for his miss the
first time. My fat guy's better than your fat guy.
To extend their lead. So here's the kickoff now as he'll
hey, that was huge in momentum.
A score. And a fair catch signal for. And
did you hear it?
Successfully. Carolina getting set to take the field.
Wow, I thought you were going to win the game. Like, no joke. I think you scored.
On the lone receiver left. They'll throw on first down with Wilson.
Oh, that's a good hit.
Collision there, jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson.
Get.
And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
I'm not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion, and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
Now, this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Goal! 9-13.
Back now at Ford Field. It's the Panthers in possession of the football, but facing a deficit here as we get to the fourth and final quarter play. They go play action here on first down. This is caught inside the 15.
Touchdown, Coleman.
Panthers have taken the lead here in the fourth.
I know these wide receivers are about crashing dash and high flying plays, but a good number of them play running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Coons on to kick this one away following the score. That'll be taken in the end zone. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense. Defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last
possession.
Come
on! Hold the block! He's not even blitzing and we can't hold the block!
And recover.
Well, that plays a statistic that's going to go on the defensive team stat sheet. Won't necessarily reflect in ours, right? The overall game sheet.
Pressure comes.
Hold the
block!
Hold the block!
Son.
You know what that is?
Drop him.
The more Viking
cheese. About eight. Wilson now off the bootleg. And he couldn't hang on to the contact. Incomplete.
It appears that the pressure is affecting him today. Normally, he knows exactly when to get rid of the football. But today, because he's been hit a few times, he's getting rid of it a little bit too quickly.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now Wilson. And this time he's got
the ball. Oh, my God.
It's complete.
First down.
It's a pickup of 19 yards on the play. And on fourth and long,
why did he do possession catch? I have no idea.
Quickly, they get to the line. Now Wilson.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they finish on completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in.
Stop, Harper!
Second down following the incompletion.
He's trying to eject the dish.
The one running back is
you got
Garland.
Michael Orr.
Second and 10. It's Wilson again. He's going to fire one deep over the middle.
Crabtree!
And he's brought down after a good game.
Place for methodically marching the ball.
I'm telling you, if I lose this game, I'm going to be mad.
In big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays. That's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Baby!
Marcus Peters. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the ball.
That's huge.
That's huge.
Gain of 3, second down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loaded in the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take.
Come on, you have the zone there for a reason.
15 yards through the air and a first down.
You have the zone there for a reason, and he's going to win the game.
See what transpires after this.
Please.
First down carry here for Charles.
Good hit.
But he can't can't rein in at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Bob line, let's go.
Off the corner, where'd he come from? Well, I guess he came off the corner, but really nice play.
I like when you're able to pose a question and answer it at the same time. That's exactly where he came from, but it's not something that you normally see. Most of the time, we're thinking about those guys covering pass catchers. In this case, he was a big factor in a run game, no gain.
Oh, Wilson gonna throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down.
Good job, Wake.
Cameron Wake.
Good job, Wake.
His second sack now in the afternoon.
We own it.
And the Lions gonna stop us momentarily as they call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Over the middle.
Yes.
Happens. And we're gonna get down. Another timeout called by the Lions. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter.
Wow, Hayden, this is going to come down to the wire.
Averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. Now Brown. 12
yards. We are going to have to drop down the field.
The Lions will take over. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
They practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. They'll look to throw. Crabtree with it. And he's brought down.
Crabtree.
Give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
26 yards on the pickup there.
I'm going to get this close to
the Detroit first down. 19. They'll come out in the pistol. He's back to throw. To the right side here, the tight end Thomas. It's a gain of 7. Second down.
It didn't check off every box. But the most important one, got the clock stopped, getting out of bounds, and a little short of the first down, but I thought that was the key.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now on second down, this is Gurley. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2.
And when the defense wins and gives up no yardage on a running play, that's something they can build on and carry themselves forward throughout the game.
So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. His first attempt of the afternoon. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their 3rd and final timeout. So as they talk things over, we'll step aside. So
why is it on the same?
Now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break.
Why is it doing this?
Dang, that camera angle sucks. So thank you guys for watching. Please give a thumbs up.